not waste my time repeating the same thing. So we'll straight away start with, can somebody quick see, and one simple request is please mute, and this will be an interactive session. Whenever you want to interact, you can unfold, sir, unmute, and you can start answering, and then again go back to the mute mode. Okay, so quickly if somebody can give us an update, what was discussed in the last class, 1 or 2 minutes, don't take more time. What did we discuss in the last class? And I'll just show you the objectives that we had set in the last class. Okay, I hope this screen is visible. We try to understand the symptoms that we already know about cocculus, and we did list the pathogenesis of cocculus, and we also listed the ailments and its effects. And probably this is where we stopped. The first three objectives were taken, and the fourth objective is what we need to understand. What we are trying to understand is, we are trying to evolve a mental picture keeping the ailments in mind. Okay, so I will quickly go through all these things which we have already done. So I'll run through. I did discuss common remedies that acts on the nervous system, and how do we differentiate that from cocculus. We spoke of agaricus, we spoke of alumina, we spoke of zincum, phosphorus. Argentum metricum we spoke, okay. We spoke of cicuta, cuprum, gelsemium. Helleborus, Nux vomica, opium. These were the remedies we already discussed. And if you want a detailed lecture, please go through the video which Dr. Harsha has already posted in YouTube. And these were the pathogenesis of cocculus indicus, its action on CNS. Okay, I'm running through because we need to start with a new topic. And see, this was something new. What we were trying to understand is ailments and its effects. Okay, initially we started with the physical ailments, and slowly we moved to the emotional ailments, and probably this is what we were trying to explore in the last class. These were the ailments that was given to you in the last class. These were the emotional ailments that were given to you. And from here, we'll take it further. And what we are trying to understand is, from the ailments, can we understand something? And as few of you interacted in the last class, we saw that there are a lot of emotions which are playing a very important role in cocculus. And we'll also try to understand if we can build a mental picture based on ailments. And we also try to understand that though nursing is a very important ailment of cocculus, not all nurses can do cocculus, because each nurse will be a different constitution, and the way they do nursing, or they do nursing because for many it can be just a duty. In cocculus, it is something beyond duty. There is a lot of emotion that is attached. That's what I'll be talking to you in the next few slides. What will happen to the person who is sick? Okay, and there are a lot of emotions that are involved here. We'll try to understand that. Now, before I start the mentors of cocculus, I'll just share a small case. Please make a note of your understanding, and once you feel that you need, you can answer, or you have something to interact, unmute, answer, and please go back to the mute mode. So this is a very recent case, 3 days back. Today is 7th, and this case came to me on 3rd April 2020. She is a lady aged around 40 years, and she presented to me with headache for last 20 days. Okay, she presented to me with headache for last 20 days. Now quickly, any one of you, what should be your next question or how do you proceed in such cases?
20 days back,
okay, so what happened 20 days back? Very good, beautiful thing. Did you have any stress? See, the duration plays a beautiful role. Now why only 20 days? Many times patients become very defensive and they tell, sir, nothing happened. If nothing happened, then why only 20 days? It could have been a month back, it could have been 3 months back. That's the beauty of homeopathy. When you start questioning, now what happened 20 days back was the first question that I asked her. Okay. And yeah, how do we proceed? Sir, I'm making it short. It's a very lengthy case so that we'll not waste time. So what is it that this lady directly told me, and this case was taken by my assistant, so my job was pretty easy here. So, you know, I asked her what happened 20 days back. And then this lady told, my husband got in touch with her ex-lover. Since then, I started with headache. This is what she has to tell her. Sir, he got in touch with his ex-lover and since then I started with headache. Now, my question to you is, can we believe this history? I hope I'm clear. Like, you know, I mean, lady telling that, you know, my husband got in touch with his ex-lover. So, can we believe this history? If yes, why?
We can believe, sir.
You can believe good. You can believe beautiful, correct? And somebody who says we should not, no. I mean, all women will tell we should believe, we can believe.
Yeah. Sometimes
the husband is next to her.
Okay, so see, this is a history.
She may be suspicious.
Okay, she may be suspicious. She might be having some delusions. See, what I'm saying is, when somebody gives you a history, please don't give them a chance to take a ride, to take you for a ride. Okay. I mean, we are sympathetic, we are empathetic, we agree. We heard her history. And I asked her, I mean, what proof do you have? Is he a man of that sort? Sir, my husband is waiting out. If you want, you can ask him to come inside. So that's when we asked the husband to come inside. And he admitted the fact that he spoke to his ex-lover over the phone on and off for past 20-25 days before he started speaking. And he just spoke and nothing else happened is his justification. You understand the case, how the case is shaping now, okay? Now what next? So husband admits, so this is not a delusion. She is not a lady who is suspicious. It is a fact that has happened. So what next?
So how did it affect on
what?
Okay, how did it?
She's very sensitive.
Her? Beautiful. Okay,
what was her reaction?
Beautiful. What was her reaction? Hello, good. So this meeting will end in 10 minutes. Asha.
Sir, okay, Kodi, sir. I'll continue.
Upgrade. Madada.
ಅಪ್ಗ್ರೇಡ್ ದುಡ್ಡು ಕೇಳ್ಬೋದು ಸರ್
ಅಪ್ಗ್ರೇಡ್ ನಾವು ರಿಮೂವ್ ಬೇಡ
ಏನ್ ಅದೊಂದು ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋದು
ಅಪ್ಗ್ರೇಡ್ ಏನ್ ದುಡ್ಡು ಕೇಳಲ್ಲ
ಹೌದು ಸರ್ ಅಪ್ಗ್ರೇಡ್ ಕೊಡಿ ಸರ್
ಅಪ್ಗ್ರೇಡ್ ಕೊಡಿ ಅಪ್ಗ್ರೇಡ್ ಕೊಡಿ
ಓಕೆ ಸರ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕೇಸ್ ಸಿ ನೌ ಮೈ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಟು ಅವರ್ ಬಾಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಡಿಡ್ ಯು ಫೀಲ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಗಾಟ್ ಟು ನೋ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ನೌ ಈಚ್ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪಾತ್ ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ಯು ನೋ ದಿ ಪೇಷಂಟ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಗೆಟ್ ದಿ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ Now, you know what was her reaction? This is the commonest reaction any Indian woman comes out with. Sir, I felt very bejaro. Tumba bejaro aito. Now, what is the meaning of the word bejaro? Okay. So, sir, he cheated me. He's a very nice guy. But, you know, how can he cheat me? He cheated me and I'm feeling very bad. Okay. And they also went to Ramaya on 18th March. And there they have given some psychiatric tablets. She did take those tablets, but she is not feeling better. She looks very dull. She looks very melancholic. And there is no appetite. There is no sleep. The case moves further. So what else you feel? I was trying to dig in deep so that if I can get anything else that I can prescribe. Aphorism 153. I was looking out for a QQRS symptom. She looks very dull. She looks melancholic. Okay. She, after further digging, she comes out and she tells me, sir, you know, the day I came to know that he started speaking to the ex-lover, I started to end my life. So she took some tablets. She wanted to take the tablets. And then she decided, why should I kill myself? There's no meaning. And she flushed all those tablets. Okay. I don't feel like eating food. My sleep is disturbed. Why did he do this to me? This keeps coming to my mind very often. Every other minute she keeps getting this thought. Why did this man do this to me? And it keeps disturbing me. Husband otherwise is a very nice guy. He has promised me he will not repeat. He also did come inside and he told me, sir, I've realized my mistake. You know, we just exchanged some notes, that's it, nothing else, some messages. I was down, so I spoke to her. I felt comfortable speaking to her. Nothing beyond that, sir. I've told my wife and I promised her, Talamal Ane Telidine, I will not repeat the same thing again. But she says, sir, I'm not convinced. And this thought keeps coming. Now, how do we proceed? Should we counsel? Should we give PL? Should we ask her to continue the psychiatric drugs that she has been taking? So these are the three questions that will come up. Okay. Talk to her. Talk to the husband. And husband has already told, no, I'm not repeating it again. Okay. So now how do we go ahead becomes a very important question. Okay. So I decided to go our homeopathic way based on our homeopathic principles. Okay, I asked her to stop all the psychiatric tablets. It was not giving any relief. Now this is the case in gist. It's a very lengthy case in gist. Now my question to you is, quickly, what rubrics can you think of? Just unmute, answer, and please mute back.
Suicidal thought, disappointment from.
Very good, beautiful. There's a rubric, suicidal thought, disappointment from, beautiful, agreed. Yeah. Anything else that you can think of?
Death from deception.
Huh? Death from deception, beautiful. That's also a rubric, good. I'll also make a note. Death from deception, suicidal thoughts, disappointment from. Any other rubric that you can think of?
Thoughts tormenting.
Beautiful.
Thoughts tormenting.
Very good. It's a nice rubric. I don't know who has contributed, but yes, it makes a lot of sense. Thoughts tormenting. Beautiful. Nice rubric. Any other rubric that you can think of? Quickly.
Being mischief.
Huh?
Being mischief.
Being?
Betrayed.
Mischief.
Mischievous. See, where is that mischievousness here? It's a real story. Fine. I mean, husband didn't do this for the sake of fun, for the sake of mischief. Nor the wife's reactions are not for the sake of mischief.
Okay, deception.
Deception. Okay, fine. Deception is
disappointment, ailments from disappointment.
Okay, very good. A broader rubric.
Broader rubric because it's a recent thing.
Yes, absolutely right. So see, one thing like
dullness, headache senior, from.
Okay, dullness, headache from. See, I'm happy like, you know, the seniors and the youngsters, a lot of rubrics that you are able to think. Now, one thing is, this is a case which is of a duration of 20 days. And as rightly said by Abhay sir, you definitely have to give importance to the ailments. Okay, fine. So now what could be the other probable rubrics that you can think of here is, I hope this is visible. These are all the probable rubrics. I didn't take them. Dwells on past disagreeable events. One, it could be brooding. The second, and the third probable rubric is thoughts persisting. Okay. And somebody beautifully used this rubric, that was thoughts tormenting. Can we quickly take up the difference between thoughts persisting and thoughts tormenting? What do you understand by the rubric thoughts persisting?
Persisting is constant
thoughts. So thoughts which keeps coming constantly. Okay. Now,
need not be tormented.
This is more of a delirium. This is more of a delirious rubric where it keeps coming to you continuously. Now, how is it different from tormenting? What do you understand by tormenting?
Being tortured or tormented by this thought.
So, in persisting, you know, when the thoughts trouble you, when the thoughts disturb you, then it will go to a higher thing and that will be thoughts tormenting. See, as I understand, see, many of the things I am trying to give you here is my understanding. I might be wrong. Don't blindly take what I am trying to give you here. Okay, but there are few things which might be hypothetical. There are few things which I have interpreted the way I want it. I might be wrong and I am open for corrections. Okay. See, thoughts persisting could be more of sorrow syphilitic. Okay. And thoughts tormenting could be more of frank syphilis. Okay. So moving ahead, another rubric that you could have thought of here was death desires. Okay. And one more you have is suicidal thoughts. Fine. And the other one is suicidal disposition. Quickly, can somebody differentiate death desires, suicidal thoughts, suicidal disposition?
Death desires is the person saying that, why am I even living? I think I should die.
Why am I living? Let me die. Beautiful.
Suicidal thoughts just come and go.
Okay.
It just comes and goes. And suicidal disposition is where that person has attempted to do something.
Beautiful. Attempted to commit suicide. Fine. See, if you just see here, I put it in the hierarchy. Death desires comes lower, suicidal thoughts comes higher, and suicidal disposition comes highest. Okay, fine. So, see, there's another rubric I thought of in this case was inconsolable. Okay, can we think of this rubric in this case? Inconsolable.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, because she's not why serving.
Inconsolable? See, now
even though the husband is telling her that.
Yeah,
she's not getting convinced.
Yes, in spite of the husband telling
her, she's lost her appetite.
Okay, in spite of husband telling her, I'll not repeat it. She's not getting convinced. Now, please, you ask her face to face, why are you not getting convinced? Sir, 10 years back, same lady, same thing happened. You're getting my point? What was her answer? Sir, 10 years back, same lady, same thing had happened, and they promised me the same. That I'll not repeat it again. Now, how do I trust him? Okay. So here we can't take inconsolable because there was a history where the husband could not maintain the promise that he had done. So I did not go for this rubric. Okay. And you have another very important thing here. 1 second. Okay. See now, why am I trying to tell you all these rubrics here is that, you know, the remedy that we are discussing next has a lot of things that will come up, okay? And we'll try to understand each of them in detail. I did not prescribe her cocculus. It's nothing to do with cocculus. The remedy was prescribed 3 days back and I had a call yesterday morning. Deception from, okay? Grief. Deception from. So that rubric was taken and they had taken suicidal thoughts because she had that thought and she was planning to take the tablets. She did not take. See, if she had taken, then it would have become suicidal disposition. I hope I'm clear. Okay. She had a thought and she wanted to take it. So the rubrics I took here was suicidal thoughts and ailments, grief, deception from, and another very important rubric I took was thoughts tormenting. Okay, I hope you understand the thoughts tormenting. She was not able to sleep, she was not able to eat, and that was constantly troubling her. And the remedy that came up was ignitia, and the remedy prescribed to her was ignitia canon. Okay, see, now after this small case, we'll come back to the topic that we had planned for today. And the topic was the mental expression of cocculus. Again, I am trying to explore teaching Materia Medica at a different angle. As told you in the first class, we spoke of the cerebellum, the midbrain, the pons, the spinal cord, and we try to link the cocculus pathogenesis. Here what I'm trying to do is, I am trying to understand, or I'm trying you people to understand this fact that the cerebral cortex has four main lobes and each lobe has some areas, okay? And you know, the emotional center, the decision making, the judgment, solving problems, controlling our behavior, planning, all these things come under frontal lobe. And under temporal lobe, we have a lot of things. Hippocampus is something you need to understand, which is part of the temporal lobe, and it plays a very important role in memory. Okay. Similarly, the parietal, and similarly the occipital. So what I want you to understand here is, this remedy, cocculus, has predominant action on the frontal lobe. Meaning, how do we justify this? Frontal and the temporal lobe. Now, how do we justify this is, when you understand the mental symptoms, what we see is, we see a lot of emotional symptoms in cocculus. Okay. So now, a quick recap. Whenever we study the mentals of a remedy, if you are a follower of Kent, how do we study Materia Medica, the mentals based on Kent's method? We classify the mental symptoms.
Will, understanding, emotions.
Beautiful. Will, understanding, intellect and emotions.
Intellect
and memory. Yeah, intellect and memory. So what I've done here is, this is something to do with will, and this is something to do with intellect, and of course we have the emotions. Understanding and memory I have clubbed under intellect. Okay. If you have to have a good understanding, you should have a good intellect. Okay. Your understanding will be based on the intellect. Your memory is also based on all those things. So instead of classifying into five, I'm broadly classified into three, the emotions, the will and the intellect. Okay. Now, next few minutes, we will try to explore the emotional or the emotional aspects of cocculus. Trimiasmatic emotional picture of cocculus is the heading that I've given. And today, next 30 minutes or 40 minutes, we will exclusively try to understand the emotions which are part of the mental symptoms of cocculus. Now quickly, what are the emotions that you can think of? Which will
anxiety.
Come under the mentals? Okay, it could be anxiety.
Grief.
Good. Grief, yes.
Grief.
Anger.
Grief, anger, yes, agreed. Huh?
Bad news, silent grief, mortification.
Okay. Yeah, mortification, bad news, good news, very good. So now, to make things more
excitement,
simpler.
Excitement, nervousness.
Yes, yes, good, excitement, nervousness.
Nervous.
Right. To make more, things more simple, what are all right. The emotions? Yes, agreed, right. What are all the emotions seen and felt by cocculus patient? Okay. See, this will be the reflection of the ailments from. If you recall the ailments from, this becomes very, very easy and very easy to understand. Now, first thing what you see in cocculus, this is the main theme of cocculus, that they are very, very caring. Okay. And there is good amount of grief in cocculus. They keep brooding. Okay. And they also dwell on past events. And there is a lot of romance in cocculus, and they are also homesick. Okay. And this tells us about the impressionable character of cocculus. Okay. And then they are very reserved kind of a person, and this image will tell us that they introspect a lot. Okay. So there is good amount of introspection. Somebody was telling about anxiety. Yes, there is anxiety. You also have fear in cocculus. Okay, anxiety, fear, and guilt, lot of guilt, lot of irritability, lot of anger. See, these are all the core emotions felt by cocculus. Okay, and next few minutes, I will try to link all these things, okay, trimiasmatically, and I'll also try to give you the meanings. And whatever related rubrics come up now, we'll try to take up those rubrics and we'll try to understand, we'll try to differentiate the different rubrics. So my objective for today is clear. We are trying to understand only the emotional aspect of cocculus, and not, we are not touching the will, we are not touching the intellect part. Okay. So to start with, the first core, the first theme of cocculus, what you see is they are the kind of people who care a lot, who worry about others a lot. Okay. So what you see here is they cares, worries, full of is the rubric that you have. Now what does this mean? Cares, worries, full of. Somebody quickly, so that it will not be boring. There will be some amount of interaction. Cares, worries, full of.
Means her husband is not well. She is feeling, she is taking her problem. Means if husband is not well, she she feels that she is also not well. And she has to take care of him very well.
Okay, so from what I understand from Dr. Harsha,
cares and worries like mother.
Okay, okay. You being a motherly figure, beautiful, good. Could be that.
So there's a peculiarity of cocculus is that cares, especially when somebody else does not eat. So they get anxious more for others. So they are very, whatever is lacking from the other person, they are more worried about that. So there's a rubric like cares, full of ravi, full of worries, eat if he does not. So that is one of the...
Now, yeah, absolutely. Rakshital has got a point here. Now, what you need to understand here is, see, there is something that you'll have to remember, that these people, especially the cocculus patients, are patients who are very caring, okay, who are very affectionate, who are very sympathetic, who are very benevolent, okay, and above all, they are very good at nursing. So these are all few things that will come up. See, now how do you apply this practically in your clinic tomorrow is, like your patient, you know, whose mother, whose mother-in-law, rarely we get good daughter-in-laws, but assuming, you know, the mother-in-law is sick and then she takes care of her mother-in-law, she feels for her, all her emotions she feels, and she takes very good care of her, and then she comes back to your clinic. Then she comes back to your clinic and she is drained. Okay, probably you can think of cocculus for her. Okay, so cares. Now, as I have understood here, it's a quality to be excessively concerned about the health, about the protection of a particular person. Okay, see, cares, worries. You have a few things in cocculus. Ailments, which comes from cares, worries. 1-3 mark is the 3 mark remedy, and the only 3 mark remedy is. Cares, ailments from cares, worries over a loved one. And see this rubric, cares full of for others. See, when I'm trying to tell you the symptoms, you should also subconsciously try to work out the miasm. Okay. Though that I kept it in the end, I'll give it to you in a chart form, what is psoric, what is psychotic, and what is syphilitic. But you know, you please also keep working. Which is a miasm that is predominant here. Okay, cares full of for others, cares full of for relatives. Now what, see, the care and the nursing, the worry can have a toll on our body. What you see here is there can be a general weakness, or there can be sleeplessness from cares and worries. Okay. Moving ahead, what you also have here is these patients, a cocculus person is a very anxious person. We'll talk of anxiety a little later, but you predominantly see that there is a lot of anxiety for others. Okay, and see, for example, they take care of so much, and something happens to the patient, patient dies, or patient does not recover, patient goes into a complication, and this is when you see cocculus going into a mode of blaming themselves. Okay, so now this is the stage where cocculus will get into that guilt feeling that I've done some mistake, chorosyphilitic, anxiety concerns, or remorse, or at a higher level, they can go into the delusions that, you know, I did something wrong, or I committed some crime. This is again in an order: anxiety concerns is chorosyphilis, remorse is psychosyphilis, frank syphilis is reproaching self, then you have delusion, wrong done, then you also have delusion, crime committed. They are all placed in an order. To make things more easy for you, caring, worrying, many of them can do. But in cocculus, you have a triangle, you have a triad. What is that? Nursing, they lose their sleep, and to your right, you also have a lot of anxiety, a lot of anticipation. What will happen to this particular patient? Okay, that is the worry. So these three things, as Kent cues, they become very important for us. Okay, so see, this entire thing, what you saw in the last two slides, they tell us about the caring nature, the worries of cocculus. Okay, now which remedies quickly come up here? What are the remedies?
Carcinosin, vanilla, ignition.
Pulsatilla.
Okay, pulsatilla. Yes, agreed. See another
vanilla.
Remedy that you can.
Ignitia.
Ignitia, yes. See, ignition again. Carcinosin, again, beautiful. See, ignitia. Arum. Yeah, I'll come to it. See, ignitia is again a very emotionally dominant remedy. Okay. And cars, you all know, they're very benevolent, they're very caring. And somebody was talking of
vanilla.
I'm really very sorry. Vanilla, I don't
phosphoric
know.
Phosphoric
acid.
Yes,
I'll come to it. Yes. Now, vanilla is something that I'm new to. I'll be happy to learn from you. But for time being, I don't know about vanilla. I can tell you about aurum. We have verified this in our practice. See, here in this case, you know, I had given aurum to a case of non-healing varicose ulcers. I shared it in a seminar recently. Now, aurum, there this lady was very duty conscious, meaning she would do all the work. But mind you, when do you differentiate or how do you differentiate aurum from cocculus is, in aurum, it's more of a duty. Okay? Sir, who else will do? I have to do and I am doing. Fine? So that care, that anxiety, that anticipation that cocculus has will be missing in aurum. So in aurum, it's more of a duty. But cocculus, it is something that comes within. Okay? One more remedy you can think of here is phosphorus. And phosphorus is also a person, you know, who is anxious about others, who is sympathetic, who is benevolent. Okay? Fine. So the next slot, what we are trying to understand here is, we'll try to understand, for example, something happens to that patient, okay, the patient does not recover. What happens next? Any idea what happens next? Person will go into grief. The person will go into grief. Now, before I talk about grief in cocculus, now what is grief? How do you define, how do you understand grief? What is grief? What is grief?
Helplessness.
What is, it's not, okay, fine, helplessness, apart from helplessness.
Intense sadness.
Okay, intense sadness. See, but one thing, if it has to be grief, then mind you, there should be a loss. Okay?
Oh,
it should be intense sadness. Intense sadness which comes out of a loss. It could be a loss of a person. It could be loss of a material, losing my husband to another lady. Not that he's dead, he's alive, but she might lose this person to another person, another lady, okay? So grief, you have to remember this in your mind. Tomorrow, whenever you use intense sorrow, somebody rightly said, but it will be completed when it means, you know, when there is some death or when there is some loss. Loss giving rise to intense sorrow is grief. Okay. Now, what happens in cocculus? That they are caring, they are loving. So naturally, grief is an emotion that will come up when they don't recover or when they die, when they are bereaved, they go into grief. Another very important symptom you also have in cocculus is they are sensitive to grief. This is the only remedy in your materia medica from radar, which is sensitive to grief. And in the syphilitic stage, because of grief, they can go into insanity. There are four remedies you'll have to remember. From grief going into insanity, one is belladonna, the other one is arsenic amyl, the other one is platina, the fourth remedy is cocculus. Okay. Now, to make it a little more interactive, other remedies for grief?
Acid first.
Yes. See, acid first is one remedy. Cephisagria, beautiful, good.
Cephisagria, pulsatilla.
Yes. Yeah, pulsatilla. That's also a 3-mark remedy for grief.
Yeah, opium.
Alumina, sorry, opium is there. Aurum is there. Lot of 3-mark remedies.
Cyclamen europium.
Yes, one remedy I would like to highlight here is phosphoric acid. Now the grief in phosphoric acid is more chronic. And mind you, always have this thing in your mind. There is grief. Now what is the effect of the grief? Now this is a beautiful thing you need to understand. Everybody's grief, they will not react in the same way. Now this is homeopathy, this is individualization. Now, how each remedy reacts in grief becomes important for us. Ignitia, they have their own way. Netram, opium, pulsatilla, fine. Aurum, naxvamika, causticum, a lot of remedies. Now, phosphoric acid, I want to highlight something here, very important. There will be grief which will be shown on the body, meaning the person can become emaciated, the person can become prostrated, yeah, weakness. There can be graying of hair, there can be hair loss. So these are all the physical symptoms that they have in phosphoric acid, which comes as a result of grief. Okay. So what happens in cocculus? So this is also very important. No? What is that cocculus does when a person goes into grief? See, the target organ in cocculus will be the uterus.
CNS.
Okay. If you remember the pathogenesis, apart from CNS, we also saw cocculus acting on the vagus nerve and the utero ovarian thing. Okay. So what you see here is, see, three very important things. Grief brings on menses. Okay. Meaning the lady has amenorrhea. Okay. And she is subjected to some grief, and then this grief brings on menses. One. And second very important thing is, it can also be an opposite thing. Grief can suppress menses. Meaning she was in a period of grief, her cycle was on 24th, somebody died, somebody she lost, and she'll not get her menses that month. She is under grief. Okay, she's grieving, she is under grief, and she will miss her menses. So it can either bring on menses, it can suppress, or she is having her menses, and then some grief happens, and the menses can continue for a long, long period. So three possibilities that can happen in cocculus, which is because of grief. This is very, very important. Grief bringing on menses, grief can suppress menses, grief can prolong. And luckily for you, this is the only remedy given in radar, wherein there is grief which is prolonged. Sorry, menses which is prolonged because of grief.
Grief.
You also see a little amount of brooding in cocculus. Now, what is brooding? What is brooding? See, I thought I'll take
thinking about past.
Okay, good. Thinking about past. Is that brooding?
Dwelling on it.
Dwelling.
Very good. Beautiful.
Brooding is thinking about one particular topic for a very long time.
Okay, thinking about one particular topic for a very long time.
Over and again.
Past disagreeable things.
Yeah, that is dwelling. That is dwelling. We'll come to it. Absolutely right. Dwelling. That will be our next image. See, brooding means, as I understand from what I have seen, see, it's a deep thought. Brooding is a deep thought about something that makes one sad, angry, or worried. So this is brooding. We'll come to it. We'll talk of the next thing that many of you are trying to connect with. And that is dwelling. Now, what is dwelling? See, brooding in cocculus is 1 mark. Dwelling in cocculus is 2 marks. So what exactly you understand from the rubric dwells on past disagreeable occurrences?
Living in the past.
Beautiful. Very good. Yes, that's what even you'll see in my notes that will come up next. Living in the past.
They refuse to move on to the future. They just keep thinking about the past.
They keep bringing that up every time and keep connecting it to everything.
Yeah. Beautiful. Agreed. See, now one simple example I would like to share here is, have you seen the cow shiving?
It has four stomachs.
Has come out with the right
rumination.
Word. Rumination. Now, what is rumination? Is it brings all that and again it keeps eating. So, what you see in dwells and past is, see, though you are here today, you live in the past. You don't live in today. Okay. So, you live in your past thoughts or you live in your past things, that becomes dwells and past. Okay, people constantly see the beautiful phrase how it goes. People constantly reliving incident from the past, and this is disagreeable occurrences. So this will be sad ones. So whatever sad events that has happened, they keep thinking. So what I want you to understand here is this could be more of rewinding. In our old movies, we used to have that flashback, no? So you keep rewinding all the old things and you keep, enjoying thinking of all those bad things that have happened to you, right? So what you also have to understand is these people who are having this particular rubric, there'll be more of a melancholic kind of constitution. And if you just see here, you also have rumination, which Dr. Shelley was trying to tell us. So it dwells on past. Now, the next thing that comes up here is thoughts persistent. Okay. This we have already discussed. So the thoughts which keeps coming. See, it need not be, bad thoughts. It need not be sad thoughts. It could be any thought. It could be a good thought. It could be a bad thought. But they keep coming persistently. And I told you, it could be a delirious rubric that you can think of. See another very important rubric that is placed below. Thoughts disagreeable, haunted by unpleasant subjects. I have taken all close things and I kept it here. Dwells on past disagreeable event is one thing. You live in your past and this is haunted by unpleasant subjects. Okay. See, now what is haunting? I feel haunted. So haunting is something negative, something
behind
more than
something.
I feel haunted. You know, we have many movies that says, the lady is
there, is somebody behind me, like
Cardo.
Feeling tortured.
No, it's not tortured. When the word tortured comes, then it will become tormenting, and tormenting will be higher.
Okay. Scared, feeling scared.
No.
Being attacked.
Haunting is something is remaining. Something is left behind.
Okay, that is left behind. Okay, done. But this is definitely not torturing. Fine. See,
it keeps coming back again and.
Yeah, this comes between dwells on disagreeable occurrences of past and then thoughts tormenting. This comes somewhere in between. Okay, so thoughts tormenting, you don't have it here in Cocculus, but you should know. See, another very important aspect of Cocculus is romantic things. Okay, it is a very and many times we keep joking. You know, a person who falls into love, we say his emotional quotient is high, and his intellectual quotient is less. If you are more intelligent, then number of people who will fall in love will be very less. Okay. Not that intelligent people will not fall in love, but if you are romantic, this is how it is told, the more romantic you are, sentimental you are, then you are more emotional. Okay. So Cocculus is a remedy which is more emotional. So what you see in Cocculus is they are sentimental, they are romantic. Only remedy in your radar, romantic girls. Though another remedy, romantic girls, the only remedy is Cocculus. Okay, and the other remedy is tuberculinum. romantic girls, fine. So they are very romantic, they are very sentimental. Now, what do you understand by sentimental? Quickly, we are running short of time. Sentimental, Andrea, now when do you take this in a practice?
Nostalgic. People who keep memories, something associated with the memory would be safe.
Very good.
They remember the date.
Yes, yes.
Time and all those.
Yeah, yeah. So whoever are sentimental in the group can, you know, feel this rubric better. Chalo. So you keep the dates, whatever gifts you have got from your boy or from your girl, you retain them. I keep telling these examples, like, you know, the first bus ticket, the first movie ticket, the first chocolate, the wrapper, you know, the first flower that you get, you know, you keep all those things safe with you. I mean, they're, I mean, see, it could be to the material, or there are sometimes people, you know, who become very romantic when they see the nature, they love scenery and all. They can also be put under the rubric sentimental. So it's a strong emotion. Definitely nostalgia should be there. Okay. Nostalgia should be there. I don't deny. Fine. So sentimental, another very important emotion you have here is homesickness.
What about them feeling emotional when they see some emotional thing happening in front of them?
Yeah, very good. I'll come to it later, but if you want, yeah, yes, if you want me to finish it here, it's a nice thought, we can finish it here. See, now, I don't know whoever the doctor has come up with this question. Now, what you need to understand here is, yeah, Sheetal, fine. So, what you need to understand here is, somebody who becomes emotional, for example, seeing a movie scene, or something, somebody suffering, you can't see that. See, there, you can take this rubric, horrible, sad stories affects profoundly. Okay? I mean, some sentimental scene is happening, some emotional scene is happening, and you know, you keep weeping, you keep crying. Fine. Many times this happens in our Sas Bahu serials. Okay, 9 o'clock show, the mother-in-law, the daughter-in-law. That's when the gel. That half an hour there will be no fights. She'll be crying. She'll give her pallu and she will give her dupatta, and you know, they're all nice. So I mean, emotional people who get attached, who start thinking like this, and you know, they get emotionally affected, then you can go for this rubric, horrible sad stories affect. There are also some other rubrics, like for example, sensitive to cruelty, can't hear cruelty, probably calcareous remedy, you can cross check. So those rubrics can be taken into consideration. Chital, I hope I'm clear. Okay, so you also have homesickness in cocculus. Quickly, other remedies, at least one or two remedies. Yes. Yeah, yeah. Antimcode, brain, yeah. See, antimcode is a remedy that is also very, very sentimental.
Yeah. Okay. Antimcode.
Very romantic. Yeah. Though they're thick skinned, but I don't know. Emotionally, they're very, very romantic. Okay. So, you know, capsicum. Now, one beautiful indication of capsicum before we move further. Sleeplessness, which comes out of homesickness, the remedy is capsicum. Sleeplessness coming out of homesickness is capsicum. Okay. Now, this is what I wanted to highlight here. And what is this?
Impressionable.
Yes. Now, impression. What is impressionable? Yes, beautiful. Correct. Agreed. Now, what is impressionable? Can you, is the image clear? Fine.
Yes. I mean,
now, what is
exactly?
Yes,
we can have a small interaction here. We'll try to understand this rubric and we'll move further. What is impressionable?
Get influenced easily, get impressed easily.
Okay,
you can convince them easily, they get influenced.
Okay, you can convince them easily. They get influenced very easily. Okay. Now, before we talk more about this rubric, see, homesickness also you need to remember. There are many remedies in our repertory which are given under homesickness. Now, how each constitution reacts to homesickness is very, very important. Like I told you, like for example, it could be sleeplessness in capsicum. Many remedies, you know, why they are homesick. Like for example, calcareous and other remedies, they need support. It could be out of timidity, it could be out of fear, it could be insecurity, it could be missing mother's love, mother's food. I mean, we don't know what exactly it is, but based on that, our remedies can change. Okay, so please, in the next level, we can take understand and differentiate. If Dr. Manohar gives us an opportunity, in the next level, we can try to understand and differentiate each remedy, why they have this particular thing. Okay, so moving ahead, impressionable. Now, can you think of some examples? Can you think of some examples? When do you take this rubric in your practice?
Students falling for teachers.
Okay. Don't you think you're okay, fine. See, now why the students
as last
peer pressure.
Okay, I mean, say talking on a social media, this might be a very, you know, bad example, but then see, a student falling for a teacher, she might have her own reasons. Okay, you have rubrics in the Materia Medica, like for example, love, you have a rubric love or false with wrong person. Okay, love,
wrong person.
False with wrong person. Love, false with person out of social context. I was sharing this in my PG class. A very well-educated girl, I'm meaning a 10th standard girl from a very high influential family, she falls in love with the auto driver. Okay, and you know, a lot of problems happen. They wanted to elope and all those things. Now here, what you need to understand is falling in love out of social context. Meaning socially, they are not equal. So the remedy is netramir. Okay. And netramir in high potency did wonders to that particular girl. Fine. So here, impressionable means you getting influenced very easily. Okay. For example,
following others,
seeing actors and actresses.
Okay, see, for example, some actor has some style, his style. Like one actor went bald in some movie, and many of his followers went bald. Okay, or someone has got a different kind of hairstyle, and you know his followers, they start following the same thing. See now, if you go a little further, as I keep trying to tell you with every rubric, even in impressionable, this question should come to your mind. Why this given constitution is impressionable? Okay. Each of them might have their own reasons why they are impressionable. Okay. Probable rubrics could be probable cross-references. Here could be irresolute person, not able to decide.
Head belongs to other.
Yeah, something higher I'm trying to tell you. If you
delusion head belongs to identity. Other. Yes,
beautiful. Yeah.
Confusion, identity of.
Yeah, confusion, identity, beautiful. It could be head belongs to others on a higher note. So keep all these things in your mind. Simple thing, some ad coming on TV. Okay, some face cream.
Salesman trying to convince.
Yeah, something like that, you know, like you get very easily influenced by that. Salesman, these people are very easy. Targets for them. Okay. They basically confuse this thing, this patient, and salesman will take you for a ride. So any idea why in cocculus they are impressionable?
They're suffering for others.
Emotional, they care about others.
Okay. More than that. More than that.
Sympathy.
Okay. More than sympathy. See, more than sympathy and more than
the emotional attachment.
Huh?
Because of their emotional attachment to others, they give more importance to another person's opinion.
Yes, more than the emotions. Okay, something close. I want you to think one step ahead. You're still thinking of emotion. Something beyond that. Somebody. Okay. Now, in cocculus, if you see further in cocculus.
Fear weakness of others.
Death, fears of fall.
Yeah.
Cure of disease
incurable. Okay, chalo. In cocculus, what we have is, see, impressionable means easily influenced because of lack of critical ability. In cocculus, basically, they are very timid people and they are very yielding people. And people who are weak-willed and people who are less intelligent. The combination of all this, in cocculus makes them impressionable. Okay, so we'll go ahead now. I am trying to touch another area in cocculus, and this area is mainly to do with the social behavior of cocculus. How are they socially? If you see this image, what do you understand? That this person is.
Yeah, Sujata, mute me. Sujata, mute me.
Unmute.
Introverted.
I mean, people.
I am confused.
The audio is clear. Okay. So, you know, what you see here?
I think meeting will end again.
Vikesar.
Yes.
Sir, meeting end agutha in 15 nimshalu anusutte.
ಹೌದಾ ನಾನು
ಮುಗಿಸ್ತೇನೆ
ಹೌದಾ ಸರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ದನ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಯು ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇ ರಿಸರ್ವ್ ದ ಸೀ ಐ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಯು ಟು ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ವರ್ಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಬಿನ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ರೂಬ್ರಿಕ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿ ಟರ್ನ್ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ರೂಬ್ರಿಕ್ ಇದೆ ಓಕೆ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿ ಟರ್ನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕೊಕ್ಕುಲಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ 3 ಮಾರ್ಕ್
ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಆಗೋಣ ತಿರ್ಗಾ
ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಕುಲಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೋ ನೌ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಟಾಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ ದೇ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಐದರ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೋವರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಐದರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾವರ್ಟ್ ನೌ ಫ್ರಮ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಸೀ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ cocculus is a remedy which is more introverted remedy okay see taciturn can anybody give their inputs what exactly they understand
by zipping of the mouth
beautiful zipping of the mouth if you
see this don't like to talk
they refuse to be a part of conversation when they don't initiate conversation
they don't initiate conversation
or yes, speaks very inclined to talk
okay talk indisposed to see there are a lot of rubrics fine reserved talk indisposed to fine see here what
quiet disposition
beautiful that's again a nice thing quiet disposition yes anything else that you can think of see here what you are understanding
left alone
yes guru wants to be left alone
wants to be left alone
yes absolutely right wants to be left alone see what I want to
mana syllabus
yes there is speaks in monosyllables okay so now what I want you to understand here is taciturn cocculus is a 3 mark remedy and here you know in taciturn there is some amount of anger or insult in the background and you don't see them talking they keep their mouth zip, somebody rightly said, or they keep their mouth shut. They are not at all communicative. Fine. Now this is taciturn. Okay. Now what are the probable rubrics that comes close here? Is related rubrics that comes close here is the other rubric is morose. In Kannada we use the word munskonodo, morose. Fine. See, morose is something to do with the mood. Okay. See, I hope you are getting my point. See, taciturn is a basic disposition. Okay, this is how they are. Fine, and morose is more situational. Okay, am I clear? I hope there is no confusion. Morose is more to do with the mood. Sometimes they are very gloomy. Sometimes they are very sulky. Fine. So this is more to do with the mood, and taciturn is more to do with the communication. Is more to do with speech. They don't speak much. Okay, fine. So cocculus is taciturn, and this is what we already saw the image. There's a lot of introspection happening in cocculus. Now, what do you understand by introspection?
Self-reflection.
Yeah, self-reflection. Looking into yourself. Okay.
Their action.
Yes, self-analysis, scrutiny of one's own thoughts and feeling. Okay. So, cocculus is a 3-mark remedy for introspection. Then, and socially, they're very timid, they're very mild, and they're very yielding. See, these three things they become very important for you. And this is where our teacher, our sir says that majority of the Indian wives, you know, they can be cocculus because they're very adjusting. Don't give this blindly for all Indian women, all Indian wives. But what I want you to understand here is, you know, this is that basic character of Indian wife. That's what is told. Fine, they're very timid, they're very yielding, they're very mild. Okay. And you also see a lot of anxiety. Moving to the next emotion of cocculus. Should we continue? You're feeling bored. It's lengthy. Mano?
Continue, sir.
We'll go ahead.
Continue, sir.
Okay, we'll talk of anxiety. Anxiety of cocculus. Now, for your convenience, I have collected the entire rubrics of cocculus under anxiety. And I've tried to give you this in a nutshell. What causes anxiety in cocculus? Okay. For example, in cocculus, the cause for anxiety could be nursing. It could be loss of sleep, which we know in cocculus. It could be night watching. It could be sad thoughts. It could be excitement, or it could be intermittent fever. What are they anxious? What are they anxious about? They're mainly anxious about the future. And another very important thing you also see here is about his family. Yes, about his health. See, now all these things will take you to the next level, and you'll see anxiety of health. What will happen in the next level? Okay. Anxiety of health, it could be his own, it could be others, it could be relatives. Anxiety for others, in brackets, I've given the miasm, I'll explain it to you after some time, why it is athletic. Anxiety in cocculus is sudden. I'm talking of the onset of anxiety in cocculus. It's sudden. And the anxiety, which is more before menses, after menses, before midnight and evening. And what fears you have in cocculus? Okay. Majority of the anxiety or whatever causes anxiety, you know, in the next level, it will go into the fear. Like, for example, fear of impending danger, fear of listening to bad news, and that anxiety of health here will go into a fear mode. Here is fear health of loved ones, fear of impending disease.
Okay, fear of,
somebody kindly mute.
Aniya Sultana. Aniya Sultana, Irfan.
So that we will have a better what you will have to understand here is the anxiety will go into the psychotic thing, that is fear. You've got fear of loved ones, fear of health. Any idea what will happen to this fear of health in the next stage, which Dr. Manohar had described us a few days back? This you also see, yes, beautiful. You also see good amount of hypochondriasis in cocculus. Okay, that will come up next. Now the last emotion that we have in cocculus here is the sort of irritability. Okay, irritability which comes from noise. They're irritable at trifles. Small things can irritate them. Irritable before menses and irritability in the morning, and irritability alternating with the cheerfulness, jesting and mirth. See the beauty, so nicely they have given. Cheerful, jesting, mirth. Can somebody quickly tell what exactly you understand by this? Cheerful, jesting, mirth. See, jesting is what?
Joking.
Yes, joking. Very good. Joking. And now what is mirth?
Mirth is happiness. Lively. A sense of happiness.
Laughing. See, this is beyond cheerfulness.
Blessed.
Okay? This is more of laughing loud.
Laughing
out of your heart. We tell that, no? This comes beyond cheerfulness. Okay. And what is vivacious? Vivaciousness. What is witty?
Liveliness.
Full of life. Lively.
Yeah, full of life is vivacious. A lot of animation. You full know, of, full life. Of life is full of life. Beautiful. Correct. Agreed. I'll stop there. Full of life. Yes. Absolutely right. Now, what is witty?
Witty is sharp,
yes.
Answering
yes.
Quickly
now,
and or
quickly, in witty, you have to be intelligent. So to, if somebody is witty, then you know he has to be intelligent. See, good
quick responses.
Sense, yes, quick sense of humor, presence of mind, intelligence, all these things play a very important role when we talk of witty. Okay, so Cocculus is not witty, he's not a very intelligent guy. And see, now there's another very important rubric for you to understand and explore: irritability, taking everything in bad part. How do you explain this? Irritability, taking everything in bad part.
Offended easily. Now,
yes, very good. Now one
gets
more.
Gets offended easily.
Lack of critical ability. They're not able to
they
understand.
They take a bad side of everything.
Yes. So you also see another area of Cocculus slowly unfolding. Now what is that is getting unfolded here is there is a little amount of esteem in Cocculus. Not to a very large extent, but anybody joking about them, they can't like jesting. Aversion to jesting, your Cocculus, and offended easily, your Cocculus. Fine. So people who can't take up all those things. Fine. So irritability.
Even then,
everything
tacit
turn
also. Tacit turn.
Okay. Taciturn, yes. Taciturn. Yeah. Taciturn is also, as I understand, could be an esteem rubric. I'm not very sure. It need to be explored. Okay. Now irritability. In the next stage, you have anger. Anger, which comes from contradiction, probably again somewhere esteem. Anger from interruption. Now, what is the difference? Anger, contradiction from? Anger, interruption from?
Contradiction if is not someone not agreeing to their views, and interruption is if they're interrupted when they're talking or doing something that they don't like.
See, the word itself, you know, English, you can understand this. When you're interrupted, you get angry. Right? And when you don't listen to them, when you go against them, that is anger, contradiction. Anger easily. Anger again, like irritability, alternates with cheerfulness, jesting, vivacity, which means almost like vivacious, lively, animated. Now here you have rage, and this rage is malicious. It is mischievous, violent, and paroxysms. Now what is this paroxysms? Something that comes and goes.
Intermittent.
Okay.
Yeah. Which is short-lived. It's not, it will not continue. Fine. So he being a very timid remedy, though there is rage, this is something that will just come and then it will go. It just burst and then it will go. It will not continue for a long period. Now what is malicious? What is malicious?
Revengeful. More than
revengeful.
Okay. Is it more than revengeful, less than revengeful?
Yes, malicious.
Yeah, see, now a lot of
okay, intention
fine.
To
here
harm.
Again, okay, see, willingness to harm, intention to harm is malice. I'll just give a small formula. Dislike. Okay, I'm going from below upwards. Dislike is a very simple emotion. You are not liking somebody. Fine. A strong dislike will become hatred. Are you with me? Dislike is you not liking somebody, and when you strongly don't like somebody and when you hate somebody, that will go into hatredness, and then you have something called as malicious. Fine. Willingness to do harm. They have done something to you and you don't forget that, and you know you give back. That is malicious. You want to harm them.
And how then, to differentiate between the vengeful and malicious?
Yeah, I'm committed. Now the next thing, that is revenge. Okay, see, revenge, you are very open about it. Fine. That again might depend upon the constitution. See, revenge is when you take it physically or when you take it whatever way it is, emotionally, whatever it is. But in as I understand, revenge is higher than malicious. Okay, fine. So here only the thought.
Maliciousness is an intention.
Maliciousness.
Whereas revenge is an action.
Yes, absolutely right. Yeah, absolutely. It's an action. You take it, and beyond that, what you have is vindictive. Higher than revenge is vindictive. See, vindictive, there will not be any logic. There will not be any reasoning to take revenge. Okay, at least in revenge, no, he has done something bad to you, and you want to take back. Vindictive, as I understand, is a disposition. Fine. This is something higher. This person is very vindictive, meaning like, you know, they want to harm or they want to take a revenge, but there may not be any logical reasoning behind why they want to take revenge. There is another rubric that comes
sadists,
from very...
Can there be sadists, vindictive people who derive sure. pleasure?
Could be. I am not very sure. Could be. But it's a very strong negative emotion. You need to understand.
Give an example of vindictive. Sir.
It's a wrong moral. Bad moral. And another
spiteful can also be taken.
What is it?
Spiteful.
Spiteful. Okay. Now what is spiteful?
They're showing the action. Like malicious is a feeling. Spiteful is showing it verbally.
Okay.
Like cracking very sarcasm, but in a higher.
That can annoy someone.
Sarcasm in a higher, annoying intentionally doing it.
Okay. You also have malicious, another rubric that will come up. Sir, not malicious, what is it? Mocking. See, mocking again is dark humor, you know. Somebody in mind, no? You have somebody in your mind and you act according to them and you try to put them down. Okay. So you also have mocking. Fine. And another rubric, the simple rubric I want you to understand here is wicked. Now what is wicked? Wicked is when you have good amount of
bad intents, all that.
Yes, but you have a tinge of cunningness in wickedness. Wicked people will be very cunning. Okay? Wicked people will be cunning. The other thing that you also have in cocculus is the sensitive part. There is a lot of sensitivity, sensitive to external impressions, sensitive to noise. But one thing I wanted to highlight here is there is also sensitive to rudeness. They are very sensitive to rudeness. And here I have made an effort to give you a chart based on the entire emotions of cocculus. I have tried to divide it in under different miasms. Few might be wrong, few might be right, few might be having all the three miasms. Okay. But this is the basic thing. Must be asked and how serious you are about this. You can modify the small classification. Some remedies, I mean some rubrics which are put under psychosis could be psychosyphilitic. Something which are put under psoric can be psorosyphilitic. Okay. So this is a basic classification. We can always improve on this. So Sora cares, and when you start caring about your loved ones and about your relatives, that could be psychosis. When you start caring about others, fine, then that will become syphilitic. See, there is a rubric in your, there's a symptom in cocculus, little concern about his health, but very anxious about others' health. So according to me, this is syphilitic. Okay. Sensitive to grief can be sora. Grief per se can be psychosis. And insanity from grief can be syphilis. Sadness, horrible things affect, sentimental, homesickness. You can come under psychosyphilis, for example, horrible things, sad stories affect. See, it all depends how you feel, how you react. Indifference to pleasure, that is syphilitic. Brooding, dwells on past. Thoughts persistent is psorosyphilitic. Thoughts haunted can be psychosyphilitic. Thoughts tormenting is syphilitic. Okay. This is the other thing that we discussed. The social part, timid, dealing, impressionable, mild. Impressionable, I put a star there. It could be psychosis, it could be syphilis. It depends. Reserved, morose comes under psychosis. Taciturn comes under syphilis. And this is the anxiety part, which we have discussed. Rage comes under syphilis, fear comes under psychosis, and anxiety comes under sora. This is the anxiety and fear and anguish. See, now I wanted to highlight one other part. What is that is? Hypochondriasis with complaints of stomach. Okay. See, in cocklers, they have a fear that they will die of gastritis. Fear of death during gastritis. And this is reflected as hypochondriasis. And in the syphilitic state, this is same symptom can be reflected into hysteria. They can go into an hysterical stage with stomach complaints. Okay. And to summarize, what we did was we tried to understand the emotions of cocculus, only the emotional part of cocculus. I explained to you the different emotions, the different meanings of the emotions, and how they can be used in your day in and day out practice. And we also try to classify them into the miasms, sorrow, psychosyphilis. And if at all you have any questions, quick questions, I'll just take up the questions. And okay, this is a small feedback. If you don't want to ask the questions directly, you can mail me. You have my number. You can either call me, mail me. And whatever I know, as per my knowledge, best of my knowledge, I'll try to clarify. And whenever I'm given an opportunity next class, I will try to understand now how we understood cocculus in the emotional thing. We'll try to understand cocculus at the level of will and intellect. So this was something new I have tried to explore. Hope you have liked it, and hope this class will somewhere help you in your practice, you know, and somewhere help you to understand or to get a better picture of cocculus. Okay, one last time, any quick queries before Dr. Manohar takes over?
I would like to add something to it, sir.
Yes.
In Kent, they've given that there is paralysis after diphtheria. This is very marked, okay. And a case was also solved because of this.
Yes, correct. See now,
and also, that, there is paralytic stiffness of limbs.
Okay. Now, answering Ramya's question, see, to make things very simple, we are yet to go to the particulars of cocculus. Fine. We have covered only the pathogenesis, the ailments from, and mentals, a part of mentals, and that is only the emotions. Fine. So long way to go. Cocculus will take a lot of time. If this learning is helpful, we'll continue exploring cocculus like this. Therefore, I was trying to tell you, in the next class, we'll try to understand will and intellect. Probably in the last class, we'll try to sum up talking the PPRS, the generals, and the particulars. Okay. Any more questions?
So the anxiety for others and whatever emotion attachment that they have for others, is it like a selfless thing, or is it like are they expecting in return? Because there is an element of esteem and respect also.
Fine.
So see, now, is it like it's selfless?
Yeah. I mean, I'll just repeat the question. This is Dr. Usma who's asking this question. What she wants to know is, anxiety for others, is it selfless or is it selfish with a selfish motive?
So it is selfless, sir.
Yeah, 1 second, ma'am. To make things very easy, there is a rubric in the repertory which says selfless, and unfortunately under that you don't have cocculus. Okay, so this is a rubric, selfless. There are some 5-6 remedies coming up. Carcinosin is one remedy there. Carcinosin is a person who can do things selflessly. So here, though there is anxiety for others, it is not as marked as phosphorus or as marked as you know, carcinosin. Fine. But the other things we need to explore, is it with an expectation or is it without an expectation? Fine. That part I'm not very clear. Probably we'll try to understand and get back to you.
Okay. Chital, you have something there to is ask. Another one rubric, indifference apathy, health has to his, only single remedy is cocculus incara.
Okay, fine. See now, this is the syphilitic thing. A person who was so anxious about his health, who had fear of his health, okay, probably in the syphilitic phase, he can go into indifference. Indifference about his own health. Fine, it's a nice rubric that Pragati has searched. Fine, we can keep this in mind. So this is more of a syphilitic aspect, and this is a single remedy, so it will become very important. Yeah, any more questions?
Sir, you were talking about desire to be silent, acetone. When it comes to, you quoted it to be because of insult or because of the esteem.
Yes.
So my doubt is, there's another rubric which Cocculus I use generally, that is talks of others' aggravation. So my understanding was because they have sensitive towards noise, and they in a social situation, they are subjected to a lot of noise. So my understanding for that was like talks of others' aggravation. Some rubric is there like that.
Okay.
So I used that. So how to correlate that with taciturn, where there's desire to be silent.
Okay. So it's a nice thing what Dr. Sheetal has raised. And when you look at Cocculus, you've got a lot of things to do with noise. And if you remember the ailments from of Cocculus, mental symptoms from noise, this is the only remedy. Okay. But we really don't know what is that mental symptom you have in Cocculus because of noise. That is not clear. Any mental symptom?
Fear is there, no,
sir.
Eh? Fear of noise. Fear of sudden noise
is there. Sensitiveness to noise is there. Noise per se is very prominent in Cocculus. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Your understanding is also very beautiful. Like, for example, that sensitive to noise, and you know, noise will irritate and they don't want to talk. Fine. That also could be a possibility. Fine. But we need to explore. But taciturn, as I understand, is what, like, for example, not talking, not communicating, or you know, more to do with speech. But we'll have to see if it is given noise aggravates or some noise under taciturn. I'm not very sure.
I didn't find anything given.
Then we'll see. We'll see what best can be done. Okay, and we'll try to understand. Okay.
Okay.
But at least remember, it's to do with speech and communication.
Okay.
Okay.
Sir.
Yeah. Any more doubts, or we'll close? We'll close.
Manor.
Okay. Yeah. Dr. Manor will take over. Thank you.